Hello everyone! Welcome to the part 3 of our player controller tutorial. In the previous video, we've created a player controller script and made our player move to the left and to the right. Now it's time to make our character jump, and by the end of this video, you will know how to do that. Let's go to our player controller script and declare a new animation reference asset. Jumping. This is a reference to our jumping animation that we've created in Spine. In addition to that, we'll need a public float jump speed, which is, as you can guess, the speed of the jump itself. Okay, let's move to the end of our script, and below the move method, let's create a new method. Public void jump. Inside this method, let's type rigidBody.velocity equals new vector 2. Then let's put rigidBody.velocity.x as the x value and jump speed as the y value. Alright, now let's call setCharacterState jumping. So this method will make our player jump and trigger jump animation. Let's proceed to the move method, and below the last else block, let's type if input.getButtonDownJump, call jump method. So, if jump button is pressed, the character should start jumping. That makes sense. Now, let's update our setCharacterState method to set the jump animation from there. Let's add the following to the very end of the method. Else if state equals jumping, set animation to jumping. The loop should be false because we don't want to make our character jump over and over again. And the timescale should be 1f, which is the normal animation speed. Let's do one more small change to this method. Let's cut the first if block and paste it just below the jumping state block. Now let's clean it up a bit, change the if statement to else, and we don't need a condition anymore. Okay, here we go. Let me explain what I've done. When this method is called, it checks whether the player is walking or not. Then maybe the player is jumping. And if it is none of the above, the player should be in idle state. That's all. And we'll play the animation accordingly. Let's switch to Unity and check how it works. First, we need to set our jump animation in the inspector. Choose it from the reference assets list, just like we did in the previous video. And let's set the jump speed to 5. Okay, let's hit the play button. Good! Looks like we didn't break anything. The player can walk, right and left, and it switches to idle when it stops moving. Let's try to jump. If you didn't change Unity settings, the jump button should be the space key on your keyboard. Pressing the space key, and the player jumps, but it is definitely not the jump animation that we've created. Look, she seems to walk on the air. Why don't we see our jump animation? Well, this issue is a bit tricky, and in order to fix it, we will use Spine Unity standard events. And as always, it is much easier than it sounds. Let's go back to our script, and first, let's update the move method. Just before the setCharacterState walking, let's add a condition. If current state doesn't equal to jumping, only then switch to walking state. Let's make sure that you've put the setCharacterState walking inside the if block. Then, let's update our setCharacterState method and put currentState equals state after all if-else blocks. So, every time the character state changes, we save the new state in the currentState variable, and we can use it later on in other methods, just like we do in the move method, for example. If we hit play in Unity right now, we can see our player's jumping animation, but it will have problems, like this, when the states are not switched properly, or the player gets stuck in the landing pose after a jump. And it is exactly when we should use the events. First, let's add a quick fix to our move method, and check whether the character is jumping before setting the state to idle. Okay, fine. Now, let's declare a new variable. Public string previous state, and then update our jump method. If current state doesn't equal to jumping, previous state equals current state. Let me explain what we want to achieve here. Before the character starts to jump, we want to save its state, so that we can switch back to it once the jump animation finishes. In other words, if the player was walking before the jump, we want him to continue to walk after the jump. That's the logic. In order to do that, we need to update the setAnimation method. After the if statement, let's type spine.trackEntryAnimationEntry equals, and then we just delete the space and bring the next line of code to this line. You can see that this line turns to red, and this is because of the timescale that we've added. Let's fix it. Remove this dot timescale equals timescale from the line and add the line below. Animation entry dot timescale equals timescale. Okay, we've fixed that one. Next, let's type animation entry dot complete plus equals, and it will automatically add animation entry underscore complete and automatically create a new method private void animation entry underscore complete. What is this line of code and what is this method? There are six types of Spine Unity animation state events: start, end, dispose, interrupt, complete, and event. As always, I'll put the link to the official documentation in the description below. Animation events are fired when something specific happens. For example, start event is raised when the animation starts, complete when the animation completes its full duration, and end when the animation is about to be removed from the track. You can subscribe to these events to perform certain actions at specific points of time. Sounds familiar, right? Exactly. We subscribed to the complete event so that after our jump animation completes, we could return our player to the previous state. Now, why did we use complete event instead of the end event? Well, according to the esoteric software, this is the best practice, and they've even said that twice on the same page. Never handle the end event with a method that calls setAnimation. We better listen to them if we don't want to make Unity freeze. Okay, time for some action. Let's remove the line of code inside the animation entry underscore complete method and add the following instead. If current state equals jumping, set character state, previous state. This is how we change the state to the previous one and set the relevant animation. Time to test it in Unity. Hit the play button. Awesome! Our player walks, jumps, and switches to idle when it doesn't move. The animations work smoothly, and our player doesn't get stuck in the wrong state anymore. I would just do one last adjustment and change the jump speed to 6. Now it looks even better. This brings us to the end of this Spine Unity character controller tutorial. If you want to add more animations and states, you can follow the same principles that I've explained earlier in this video or in the previous one. You can also improve the jump logics by checking whether the player's feet are on the ground before the jump, but it is not related to Spine Unity Runtime, therefore it is not covered here. Thank you so much for watching this video, and if you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more tutorials from us, please consider subscribing to our channel. Thank you, and good luck with your game.